Redbirds coming off a very memorable season last year, a great run into the postseason. And coach, what do you expect from your team this year?
Well, we're really optimistic, and you know, I think there's a lot of unknowns yet, and we certainly look good in the off season. We have had a great summer, great fall, but it's a lot different once the lights go on, and time will tell. But we're very optimistic. I think collectively, this is the hardest working group that I've been around since I've been here at Illinois State. I love our chemistry. I love our work ethic. I love our discipline. And I think we've got some very talented players. And so I think it should be another fun, successful, and memorable season for us.
Well, let's talk about the team chemistry. Four returning starters. Very few teams around the country can actually say that. What does that mean for you guys?
I think it's tremendous for us. It's you know, something that a lot of teams, like you had said, don't have the luxury to have. But our, you know, this is what you hope when you build a program. You hope that your upperclassmen will take those underclassmen under their wing and just you know, emphasize the expectations. You know, the way we do things in our program, and they've done a tremendous job with that in the off season. I think they've prepared our underclassmen well. I love our chemistry. I think we've got. Just a very unique group and a group that's very driven, very determined to take on their own identity this season.
Let's talk about your backcourt for a second. You're returning Maggie Crick. You don't return Christy Cerrone. I mean, you have to mention it. Someone who's been such a key part to your program has now moved on, now playing over in Greece. What do you see out of your backcourt?
Well, certainly Christy's been a tremendous player for us and so fun to coach. And all players have to go, all teams have to go through that when they lose those impact players. But I think our kids are really excited about the opportunity to step up and create their own identity. I'm excited about our backcourt. Obviously, we don't have the experience that we've had in the past couple years at that point position. But I think Amanda and Alexis both bring two different sets of strengths. And I think they're both going to do a tremendous job for us. And we'll tag team that position a little bit. But I like what I've really seen in this offseason. I think we've got some veteran players. And obviously, Maggie Crick and Shayla Jackson. I think you add Hannah Spanish to the mix, who a lot of people haven't had a chance to see yet because she was a transfer and had to sit out, but just a fierce competitor. And I think Katie Broadway's had a tremendous offseason, so we've got a lot of versatility and I think a lot of talent.
Well, let's talk about the other side of the offense then, the front court. Nicole Lewis, Ashlyn Bracey, just a fantastic duo. What do you expect from them?
It is. Unfortunately, we're not going to have Kenyatta Shelton in that mix, who's been a tremendous player for us, and just excited about the opportunity that she's going to be back that fifth year. But Nicole Lewis and Ashlyn Bracey both have a ton of experience. Very talented players, kids with great work ethic, kids that have been in the league for 3 and 4 years now. You add Emily Hanley to that mix and the versatility of a Hannah Spanish, who could be thrown in the mix as well. I'm excited. I think they're excited. They're in a position where they're going to see maybe more minutes that they have in the past because of our lack of depth. But I think they're kids that have the athletic ability and the stamina to handle those kind of what we're going to need from them.
A tough non-conference schedule. And it's a tough schedule no matter what team is playing that non-conference schedule. But then you're a team without a returning point guard. And one could be, you're going to see a freshman in there, one starting in Amanda Clifton. What is that schedule going to mean for you heading into Valley season?
It's going to be a great warm-up for us. And we're going to be challenged in a lot of different ways. And I think it's certainly going to help us get prepared for our conference, which I think is going to be extremely tough again this season. But I think it's only going to help us and be beneficial. We're going to be tested early. We're going to, I'm sure, have some bumps in the road. But the good thing is I think we've got a number of kids that we can kind of rotate in at that position. Again, they have different strengths, but I there's no doubt in my mind that we'll be able to find a way to get things done early on.
One thing you brought up in the Media Day press conference was your coaching staff, and you're still together. Talk about how much is that going to help you.
Well, I'm so blessed. I think I've got some of the best coaches in the country. And you know, Randy Norton as my associate head coach has done a tremendous job for us. Willie Cox, Jenny Putnam, Taryn Martin, and now Heather Page, who's on staff. They've been tremendous, every single one of them. They've got a great understanding of the game, very knowledgeable. and they do so many things behind the scenes. But, you know, just to have that cohesiveness and that chemistry from our staff, I really believe it trickles down onto our players. And that's something you don't see a lot of in this day and age in this kind of profession. But I think it's been instrumental to the success that we've had, and fortunate that they're some of my closest friends as well. And we've had a lot of fun building this program.
We're in a very empty, quiet Redbird Arena right now. A couple months ago, it was not that way at all. That postseason run was fantastic. The crowds were great. I'm sure you're hoping for the same thing this season.
Absolutely. It was an amazing run, and I think our fans really appreciated how hard our girls played, and I know our staff and our players really appreciated the kind of support we had. No doubt about it, we wouldn't have been in that position without them last year, and I just hope we can pick up where we left off. That's what you hope for every season. I think our fans are really going to continue to enjoy the style that we play. It's going to be run and gun, very up-tempo, baseline to baseline. And I think our kids work so hard, and I think they're great role models for this community. And I hope that we can pick up where we left off and continue to build from there.
One final question for you, Coach. I know it's not for a couple months, but the Valley, what do you see from the league this year?
It's going to be tough. I think there's a lot of unknowns, a lot of injuries to some key players from a year ago, some graduation of some other players. I think this non-conference, we're going to learn a lot about each other without seeing actually playing each other, but I think it's going to be tough. There's a lot of parity. I've got a lot of respect for the coaches in this league, and I think it's certainly going to be up for grabs.
Well, Coach, it was a great year last year. I know we're looking forward to it again. Good luck.
Thank you very much.